Hi everyone, I'm Nico, and today's video is an introduction to the 7 most useful Excel functions. I'll eventually create in-depth tutorials on each of these functions, so let me know in the comments which ones you want to see first. Also, let us know how many of these you're already comfortable with. Now, the first function you need to know is the sum function. It's used to do exactly that, calculate the sum of a bunch of values. The simplest way to use it is to add up a single range. So let's add up the sales in the first quarter. I'll type equals to start the formula, sum, open bracket, and then click and drag to select the range that I want to sum. And I'll press enter, and there we have the total. We can see that it is summing up the 4 cells above. If I click the little square in the corner and drag it across, we can see that the formula is dynamic. It has changed, and in each column, it's moved up to display that same shape, the 4 rows above. Now also, for each formula, I'll just display the formula text over here. It's just for your reference to make it easier for you to pause and analyze the formula or to write it down. Now we can also add values in multiple ranges. So let's say we want to add all of Sally and Lucy's values. I'll go equals sum, open bracket. I'll select all of Sally's values, then comma, and now I can enter another range. So I will select all of Lucy's values and close the bracket, press enter. And there we have it, the total of both sets of values, 2,378. Now we can also automatically add without having to type equals sum open bracket. We do that by just pressing Alt equals. Now Excel guesses what we want to add. We can either just press enter to accept it, or we can now go ahead and just select the range that we actually want to add and press enter. The next function we are looking at is the average function. Now, the average function is very similar to the sum in that we select a range of values and Excel calculates the average of those values. In other words, it sums them all up, but then divides it by the number of items to give us the average. Now, once again, we can calculate the average of a single range. Let's do that for Harry. We type equals AVER. And we can see it there at the very top, so we can now press tab and Excel auto-completes the name of the function and puts a bracket for us. Now I select all of Harry's values and press enter. We can see the average for the 4 quarters is 272. Now we can again copy it down and we can see it copies down that same shape, the 4 cells to the left. We can also again calculate the average across multiple ranges. So let's again look at Sally and Lucy's values together. Now in Excel, we can hold the Control key and select multiple ranges. Now we can actually also do that within a formula. So let's try that now. We type equals, type AVER until average is at the top, press tab, and now I'll select the first range. But then I'll hold the Control key and then select the second range. So you can see the formula has the first range for Sally, comma, the second range for Lucy. And I can close the bracket or just go ahead and press enter. And you can see it calculates the average value across all of Sally and Lucy's values, which is 297. Next, we'll look at the min and max functions. Min and max are similar to sum and average in that we just select a range of values and then Excel either brings back the smallest value in that range or the largest value in the range, with min for the smallest and max for the largest. Now let's go ahead and calculate the smallest value in the whole range. We'll type equals min open bracket, select the entire range and press enter, and we can see it brought back minus 17. Now let's calculate the largest value in the range. We'll type equals max open bracket, select the entire range, press enter, and we can see it brought back 172, which is clearly the largest value in the range. We can again look at multiple ranges. So let's calculate the smallest value across quarter one and quarter four. To do that, I'll say equals min, open bracket. I'll select all of quarter one, and then while holding the control key, I'll select all of quarter four. And we can see it selected the two ranges there for me, and I'll press enter, and it brought back 26. Now we'll find the largest value across quarter one and quarter four. To do that, we'll say equals max, open bracket. I'll select all the values in quarter one. This time I'll go comma, select the next range, close the bracket, and press enter. And we can see it brought back 172. Okay, now we will have a look at the count function and the count A function. We'll again look at those two together. The count and count A functions are used to count non-blank cells in a range. The difference between these two functions is that with count, we only count the cells with values in them, and with count A, we count all non-blank cells, whether it has values or text. Now in this table, we can see the test results of a class of students. We want a formula that tells us how many students there are in total, and we also want a different formula to tell us how many students actually sat the exam, so excluding the ones that were absent. Now in the first cell, we'll calculate the total number of students who actually sat the exam. To do this, we want to count values only, so we'll use count. I'll go equals, count, open bracket, and then I'll select all the cells to evaluate. I'll select the whole range and press enter. And we can see the result is 17. In the next cell, we want to display the number of students who are enrolled, whether they sat the exam or not. So this will obviously include the absent students. So again, I'll select all of the results, but this time I'll count using count A. So I'll start with equals, count A, open bracket. Again, select all of the results, close the bracket and enter. And we can see the result is now 19. So we can see we've selected the same range for each of them, but with count, it only picked up 17, being the numerical values only. And with count A, it picked up 19, as it included the text values as well. Now I'm going to select this range, and then I want you to have a quick look at the status bar down here. You can see that whenever we select a range of values, Excel automatically calculates all of the values that we've looked at so far. The sum, the average, the count, the numerical count, the min, the max. Now you may not see all of them, so to add or remove some, you can right click on the status bar and then tick the items you want to add or untick the ones you want to remove. Okay, the next function we are looking at is the if function. The if function tests to see whether a certain condition is met, and then it returns either one result or another, depending on whether the condition is true or false. Now in this example, we have a table of results, exam results, and the condition we want to test for is whether the score is greater than or equal to 60. If the condition is true, we want the cell to display pass, otherwise it should say fail. Now we can see the if function needs three arguments, or things between the brackets. The first is the logical test, so the condition that we want to test for and see if it's true or false. The next argument is the value to display if the condition is true, and the last argument is the value to display if the condition is false. Now let's go ahead and build our formula. I'll type equals to start a formula, then if, open bracket, and we can see the first required argument is the logical test. So for that we say score. Now where's the score for this individual? It's in C13. So the score greater than or equal to 60. That's the condition that we will be testing. If that is true, comma, now we indicate what's the value if true. We want to say pass. Now that's a string of text, so we'll put it in double quotation marks. And that's it. Then we'll move on, comma, moves on to value if false. What's the value if false? Again, in double quotation marks, we want to state fail. Close the double quotation mark, and that's it. If C13 is greater than or equal to 60, if that's true, then display pass. Otherwise, display fail. I'll close that bracket and press enter. And we can see it works perfectly. Mr. Jackson here had a score of 56, which is less than 60. So it jumped straight to the value if false, and it returned fail. I'll double click here on the little square to copy the formula down. And we can see that it worked every time. 47 is a fail, 72 is a pass, 67 is a pass. Okay, that's all I have for you today. I really hope you enjoyed it and learned a couple of things. If you did, please remember to hit the thumbs up button. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to make sure you don't miss out on any upcoming Excel tips and tricks to save you some time and to make your work easier. Thanks, guys. See ya.